court will now reconvene. Prince Blueblood, has the police brought the results of the hoofprint analysis?
Yes, they have, Your Honor.
Then please share your findings with the court. Well, don't just stand there looking irritated. Say something!
It's just as the defense claims. The hoofprints don't belong to either the defendant or the victim.
So, do they really belong to one of the other contestants in that fashion contest?
Yes, well, just as Princess Twilight requested, we compared the prints found backstage and on the catwalk to those of the contestants. Apparently, some observant pony down at forensics noticed that only one contestant has any connection to any pony involved in this case. He checked their prints first and found a perfect match.
Wow. Can I get that guy in all of my future cases, please?
You actually found a match? Then please tell us, whose hoof prints are they?
The hoof print analysis has concluded that the one who left those hoof prints at the time of the crime was a mare by the name of Suri Polomare.
Suri Polomare?
So, Twilight was right after all.
We subpoenaed her during the recess. She has just arrived and is waiting in the witness lobby, Your Honor.
Then please bring her to the stand at once.
Name and occupation, please.
This is ridiculous. I was in the middle of something very important, and then the police barged into my apartment and demanded that I accompany them to the courthouse. Some nerve.
Witness, I would appreciate it if you would state your name and occupation for the record.
I need to finish my dresses before tomorrow. I'll be ruined if I don't finish soon. Can't you all see that I'm a very busy mare? You don't just drop in on some pony like me and take me away from my tooties, okay?
Witness! Name! Occupation!
Fine. Suri Polomare, I am a fashion designer.
Miss Polomare, are you aware of why you are called to the stand today?
No, I am not. The police who showed up at my apartment didn't tell me a thing.
You are called here because you are suspected of murdering a costume designer by the name of Overall Concept.
What? Murder? I did no such thing. I'm too busy dealing with my own problems to commit something so heinous.
I see.
Really, Your Honor? That's all you have to say to that?
Well then, does the defense have any objections?
As shocking as it may sound, I do, Your Honor. Based on the analysis that the prosecution revealed, the hoofprints belong to Miss Polomare. She must have been the one who made them at the scene of the crime, which means she must also be the one who stole Overall Concept's special fabric and murdered him!
A human is here to accuse me of something I didn't do. Don't make me laugh, okay?
Then how do you explain these hoofprints left behind? The analysis clearly shows that they're yours!
Now you listen here! I didn't commit any sort of theft or murder, but if it makes you feel any happier, I'll tell you what I was doing that night.
You're actually going to cooperate?
It's not like any of you are giving me a choice. Besides, I'm in the middle of something very important, so the sooner I get out, the sooner I can get back to work.
Well, we appreciate your cooperation, Miss Polomare. Now please testify as to your whereabouts at the time of the incident.
I guess I can't really hide this. I was indeed at the play that night. It was during the intermission that I went to the dressing room to meet up with Coco. As soon as the second act started, I took a casual walk backstage. I went up the catwalk, walked across, and went back down on the opposite side. I then went out the back door and left the theater before the incident happened.
So, You admit that you were actually at the theater.
Don't act so surprised. I never denied that I was. Now look, I am in a hurry right now. I've said what happened. Can I go home now? I have more important things to do, okay?
Then you better hope I don't find anything that makes you stay longer.
Indeed, Mr. Wright. You may now cross-examine the witness.
I guess I can't really hide this. I was indeed at the play that night.
Hold it! You said you were busy earlier. Were you also this busy on the night in question?
Of course I was. I'm currently in a fashion contest and the dresses need to be finished soon. I'm not done yet, so I need all the time I can get to finish them. Like the time you're all wasting right now.
Is the contest really that important?
Of course it is. This contest can make or break a designer's career.
If this contest is such a big deal, why did you go to the theater?
I needed a break. I felt going to the theater would help me unwind. I knew Coco Pommel was working there, so I thought I might as well give her a visit.
You met with Miss Pommel.
What exactly were you doing with the defendant, witness?
It was during the intermission that I went to the dressing room to meet up with Coco.
Hold it! You went during the intermission.
I was late getting to the theater, so I couldn't make it backstage before the play started. When the play went on break, I figured it was the best opportunity to get backstage.
But aren't the staff in the theater guarding the stage? I find it hard to believe that they would let someone in the audience go backstage.
I've been to the theater many times, so the staff are quite familiar with me. They just let me through.
But the staff didn't mention anything about you going backstage.
That's probably because they had no reason to. I wasn't there when the crime occurred, after all.
In that case, why didn't Miss Pommel mention anything about you?
Miss Pommel could have easily lied about any pony else being involved.
I find that very hard to believe. If she actually didn't want to get caught as the murderer, she would have mentioned a third party was involved right from the beginning. In fact, not mentioning just that makes your previous theory rather unlikely. Why would my client try so hard to create false evidence and then not even bother to mention that a third party was there? Especially if there actually was one there!
Who knows what the defendant was thinking? Unless you have a solid objection to this testimony defense, I suggest you move on.
Very well. That leads me to my next question. Why did you meet with Miss Pommel?
That is none of your concern.
I beg to differ. Your business with Miss Pommel has everything to do with this case.
Well, if it's that important, I was just there to visit her.
Visit her? For what?
Nothing in particular. Just to see her.
From what I hear, the two of you aren't exactly on good terms. Miss Pommel said she used to be your assistant, and she quit.
Our professional history is irrelevant. I was just there to see her again for old time's sake and put everything behind us.
So, what did you talk about?
Nothing much. I was wondering how she was doing. She and her friend were just working on this fabric as we talked.
Special fabric? Did you know about the fabric prior to your visit?
No, this was the first time I'd heard about this fabric. They let me have a look, and I even touched a bit. Very soft fabric, I should say.
So she felt the fabric. That would explain how she got paint on her hooves to make the hoof prints. As for the path itself, though...
As soon as the second act started, I took a casual walk backstage.
Hold it! Took a casual walk around?
Well, I was finished with our conversation, so I just figured that looking around backstage was a good way to unwind. The area was way bigger than I thought, so I couldn't help but wander around looking at everything. It reminded me of the last fashion competition I was in, and of seeing the models wearing my designs on stage. If only I had won the contest, I would... But that was months ago. I am far too busy to talk about my past accomplishments.
Or lack thereof, according to Rarity and Coco. Couldn't you have just watched the show instead?
If I decided to watch the show, then I would have gotten too distracted to get back to work on my dresses. But I still was a little curious about the play, so I took a little peek. From a different perspective, you could say. I went up the catwalk, walked across, and went back down on the opposite side.
Hold it! Went up to the catwalk.
I wanted to see the play for a short bit before I left. I must admit, the height was very intimidating, but it sure was a great view.
But neither playwright nor the stagehooves mentioned anything about you going up to the catwalk. Why would they not mention you being backstage, especially since you're not part of the audience or the staff?
Objection!
If you recall playwright's testimony, you would know that he was paying attention to the play. He only looked at the catwalk because he heard ponies running. This witness had no reason to make any sort of ruckus, so it's possible that she went up to the catwalk quietly without any pony noticing, especially since backstage was dark at that moment.
Unfortunately, I can't deny that. It would explain the hoofprints, but I don't believe that's the right explanation. It has to be something else, and I'm going to show her why all of this is false.
Any final statements, witness?
I then went out the back door and left the theater before the incident happened.
Hold it! Just so we're all clear, you came in through the main entrance and left through the back door. That's what you're saying.
That's correct.
Would you mind adding this to your testimony, for clarity's sake?
If it means I can leave soon, then fine.
The witness will add this clarification to her testimony.
I entered the theater via the main entrance and left through the back door before anything even happened. Happy now?
Objection! Miss Polomare, there's a significant contradiction in your testimony.
What?
I see no such contradiction, human. Stop trying to force your reasoning when the trial's not going in your favor.
Like you're one to talk.
Mr. Wright, would you care to explain this contradiction to the court?
Certainly, Your Honor. Suri claims that she left the theater before the murder took place, and therefore she has no connection to this case. Well, I have it on good faith that this claim is a bold-faced lie.
And what evidence do you have to support that statement?
Well, first, let's clear up a separate issue regarding Suri's movements that night. She mentioned that she entered the theater through the front, which was where the audience sat. I find that very odd.
Odd? But she was an attendee. That's where every pony goes when they enter the theater.
You're right. That's where the audience goes. That is, if you're actually a part of the audience.
Explain!
The witness said that she was late to the theater and arrived after the play had started. According to your own words, Prince Blueblood, the show in question was sold out around noon that day. It was actually Coco who purchased the last ticket and gave it to one of her friends as a gift. This means that if Miss Polomare just went to the theater on a whim, she would have had no way to get through the front door to get inside the theater.
Order! Order! Witness, have you been lying to this court?
No, of course not. I must have gotten confused. What with the stress of this competition. I bought my ticket a few days in advance, so I was still able to get into the theater without any problems.
Even if that were true, that doesn't solve the biggest issue with your claim.
There's another?
Oh yes, and this will be the one that will reveal just how closely connected you are with this case.
Please explain, Mr. Wright.
Of course, Your Honor. The police made sure to interrogate all 5,000 attendees in the theater. If you really had bought your ticket, then the police would have discovered your absence immediately. They would have only interrogated 4,999 members of the audience. That means the only possible explanation for this inconsistency is that you were never part of the audience.
No! This can't be!
Miss Polomare, it seems more and more likely that you've perjured yourself. What do you have to say to explain this?
Isn't it obvious? I went back to my seat after I saw that it was raining outside. Jeez, why are you picking apart every insignificant detail?
You went back to your seat. How did you do that?
What do you mean, how did I do that? I walked back through the stage wing and returned to the audience.
Objection!
Unfortunately for you, that is impossible.
Why?
If you recall, the stage wings were being watched during the second act of the play. There were stage hooves in the right wing, while playwright and his stage manager were in the left. Even if they could have somehow failed to notice the witness going to and from the catwalk, there's no way they would have missed her walking right past them.
Objection!
But the right wing was empty following the incident. She could have made her way back to the audience at that point.
Yes, that's exactly what happened. I went back to my seat when the wing was empty.
Then the police obviously took your name down when they interrogated you, correct?
Tartarus with you, you filthy human!
Well, Prince Blueblood, was this witness among those who were interrogated?
No, she was not.
What? How dare you?
So, as we can see, the witness was not among those interrogated, the total number of which added up to a full house of 5,000. This, in addition to the glowing hoof prints, conclusively proves that Suri did not enter the theater as a member of the audience. She came in through the back door with the express purpose of stealing a roll of overall special fabric.
Witness! Explain yourself at once! Witness?
So, this is how far the equestrian royalty have fallen, huh?
What?
How pitiful. You can't even protect a damsel in distress from being falsely accused.
Now see here, I am trying my hardest to help—
Shut up! I do not believe I gave you permission to speak.
Excuse me? I am a prince, I'll have you know. The nephew of Princess Celestia. You should treat me with the respect I deserve.
Respect? Don't make me laugh. A prince who uses the power he's borrowing from his aunt for no other purpose than to grant himself prestige among the elites of Canterlot isn't some pony worth respecting.
How dare you!
Simmer down. The adults are talking now, okay?
Miss Polomare, restrain yourself or you will be held in contempt of court!
Jeez. And here I thought a pony couldn't get any more intimidating. Twilight?
What did she mean this is how far the equestrian royalty have fallen?
Huh?
Now, witness, please explain to the court how you came to be at the theater on the night of the murder.
Fine, I admit it. I was not there as an audience member.
So you were lying to us?
Yes, I was.
Witness, what are you doing? You realize that lying to the court would make me look—
Shut up! Why should I care about how it makes you look? I don't recall you actually helping me out.
I beg your pardon? You dare talk back at me, witness? In case you hadn't noticed, I'm trying to save your sorry flank!
Then how about you stop sitting on yours and make yourself useful for once?
Are you really challenging my patience?
Your patience? I've been trying to be patient ever since I got here, and I have no time to be patient! I have dresses to work on!
Honor in the court! Witness, you've just committed perjury! But I will allow you an opportunity to clear the air. I suggest you take it rather than argue with the prosecution. Now, why would you lie to this court?
Maybe if you would all just be quiet for one moment, I can explain.
Explain?
Let's cut to the chase, shall we? You're trying to say that I stole the fabric and killed the costume designer, correct?
That's right. Uh-oh. Why do I have a bad feeling about what she's going to say?
If that's the case, then why wouldn't I have just left the theater after stealing it? I had no reason to stick around and murder Overall, correct?
But what if he caught you trying to escape? You'd naturally want to stop him from catching you.
Stop him, perhaps? But there are several ways to do that without killing him, okay?
Well, perhaps you had some sort of hidden connection to the victim that we don't know about yet.
In that case, Your Honor, I would like to testify regarding my connection to this pony Overall concept.
Okay.
What are you doing, witness? I'm supposed to be the one to call for things like that.
Then how about you actually do your job instead of waiting for me to do it for you? Maybe if you were actually competent at your job, I wouldn't be standing here having my name dragged through the mud and my patience tested because of this human attorney's endless questioning. If you want something done right, you do it yourself. Ugh. I can never rely on others to do work for me anymore. Like I always say, it's every pony for themselves in the big city.
Well then, witness, please testify to the court about your connection to the victim.
I admit, I wasn't part of the audience. I noticed that the tickets were sold out, so I figured I'd come in the back door. The reason I came to the theater was to visit Coco Pommel and nothing else. It was then that I first met Overall Concept. After my visit, I left the theater. I had no reason to kill the victim.
So, is that all you have to say, witness?
What else can I say? That's all that happened.
It's quite a short testimony for us to dissect.
Then all I need to do is press for more information. She's bound to reveal something.
Very well, Mr. Wright. Please begin your cross-examination.
I admit, I wasn't part of the audience.
Hold it! You acknowledge that you willingly trespassed in the theater.
Yes, but it wasn't as if I was gonna harm somebody. Besides, it's not like any of you have ever trespassed before.
There's a big difference between a cattle ranch and a big city theater, you know. Were you planning on buying a ticket?
I planned to, but... I noticed that the tickets were sold out, so I figured I'd come in the back door.
Hold it! Were there no other entrances in the theater?
The only one I knew was the back door.
And there were no ponies guarding the back door?
I'm pretty sure I wouldn't be in this mess if there were guards in the back to stop me, wouldn't you say?
Point taken. So what did you do once you went inside?
The reason I came to the theater was to visit Coco Pommel and nothing else.
Hold it! Why did you want to visit Miss Pommel?
She invited me to come over.
So you were a guest?
Yes. I actually went there because Coco gave me a letter that day to come to the theater near the end of the play.
A letter? Coco didn't mention anything about a letter to Siri. This has got to be another lie. Do you still have this letter by any chance?
Not with me, but...
She hesitated, so she probably was lying. Then how do we know that everything you just said was the truth?
I suppose you can't know for certain, but you absolutely cannot see that letter.
She's really aggressive about this letter, but I don't have any proof that this letter was there or not. Guess I'll come back to this when the time comes. So, what did you do after you arrived at the theater?
I talked with Coco for a bit, and... It was then that I first met Overall Concept.
You never met the victim before that point?
No, but I've heard of him. I mean, who hasn't? He earned his fame a few years ago in the same fashion contest I'm participating in. Something I'd like to get back to working on.
That checks out with what Blue Blood said earlier. Did you talk to him at all?
No, he was too consumed by his work. He was busy with a sheet of gorgeous fabric at the time.
I see. And what did you do after your visit with Coco?
After my visit, I left the theater. I had no reason to kill the victim.
Hold it! You did have a reason! You went to steal the fabric!
Even if I did, which I didn't, by the way, I wouldn't have needed to kill Mr. Concept in order to get away with it.
But he was chasing you. You had to get him off your tail somehow.
I would think that hanging some pony would be considered a bit extreme if all I wanted to do was get him to stop chasing me. Am I right?
Mr. Wright, do you have any evidence to disprove Miss Polomare's claims about having no motive to kill the victim?
What should I do? I don't have anything that shows a connection between Suri and Overall. And I can't deny the fact that murdering him to get away with a theft is too extreme. Especially since we know that the victim was knocked unconscious before he died.
Hey, Twilight, any ideas? Twilight?
Oh, sorry. What were you asking me?
Suri's motive for killing Overall. As much as I hate to say it, I can't help but think that she wouldn't kill him if she could have made a clean getaway.
Perhaps she didn't have a motive to kill Overall after all, then. Perhaps her motive for murder is actually related to someone else instead.
Oh! Good thinking, Twilight.
Well, Mr. Wright, do you have an answer?
Your Honor, the defense is willing to concede that the witness did not have a direct motive to kill the victim.
You see? So you finally acknowledge that I'm innocent.
Not quite. You didn't have a motive to kill the victim, but you did have a motive to hurt someone else.
Mr. Wright, are you suggesting that there were two victims that night?
Indeed I am, Your Honor.
Shut up!
What nonsense is this? There was only one victim at the theater that night, Overall Concept.
Your Honor, I would like the witness to add that last statement to her testimony.
What?
I'm not sure how this will help, but I guess I'll follow along. Witness, please add that last statement to your testimony.
There was only one victim at the theater that night, Overall Concept.
Objection! Only one victim, huh? It seems you've forgotten about someone else who ended up as a victim in this case.
What are you blathering on about, attorney? Overall Concept was the only pony who was killed at the theater that night.
But that doesn't mean he was the only victim.
Quit wasting my time and just say what you want to say, okay?
Very well. It's true Overall Concept was the one murdered, but being murdered isn't a requirement in order to become a victim.
I'm just as confused as everyone else. Could you please explain, Mr. Wright?
For example, someone being the victim of assault. And while the victim was assaulted before his death, someone else was also attacked at the scene of the crime. Pamel.
Miss Pamel? You mean with that stain on her mane?
Yes, that's exactly what I'm saying.
Objection!
So what does that prove? It doesn't prove that the witness was the one who caused that mark on her mane.
Objection! While it's not exactly proof that she was the one who attacked Miss Pamel, it would establish her motive for murdering Overall.
Her motive?
Think about it. After Miss Polomare was able to knock Overall down, all she needed to do was run away. As she said herself, she never knew the victim, leaving her no reason to commit murder.
Finally, you understand. I told you I wouldn't want to do something like kill him.
But then some pony else gave you a reason.
What's this now?
What do you mean?
You know who Coco Pamel is, correct?
Is this a joke? I've already mentioned I do.
And what was your past relationship with her again? Before you say anything, I should warn you, both Rarity and Coco are listening. And I'm sure they'd be willing to testify to the truth if the need arises.
Objection!
What does Miss Polomare and Miss Pommel's past relationship have to do with any of this?
I'll gladly explain. When I spoke to Miss Pommel and Rarity, they had some very negative things to say about Miss Polomare. In another fashion contest that both Rarity and Siri Polomare had entered, Miss Polomare stole some of Rarity's own special fabric to make dresses with, and took all of the credit. Yet, it wasn't even the witness who made the dresses. Coco made them.
What?!
But that's not all. At the end of the contest, she lied to Rarity by saying that she had lost, and made Coco lie to her as well. In response to her dishonesty, Coco quit as Miss Polomare's pupil.
You're saying that this witness has a history of lying and cheating?
So what? Even if I did any of that, how does this have anything to do with this case?
It's actually got everything to do with it.
Really?
Now that we know their history together, let's bring it back to the current incident. Miss Polomare could have just knocked out overall concept and left with the special fabric, but a certain former pupil was right behind him.
Yes, that would be Miss Pommel. Oh!
With Coco Pommel in the picture, it changes everything. I think anyone would have some feeling of animosity towards someone who called you out as a liar and a cheat in such a big contest. Am I right? Maybe the feeling was so deep-seated that you would do anything to get back at them. Maybe even frame them for murder?
What? Order! Order! Mr. Wright, explain what you mean at once!
Your Honor, the witness's motive in this case is not actually tied to the victim at all. Her motive was revenge against her former pupil, Coco Pommel.
You're saying that the witness killed someone simply to frame another for their death?
Exactly. Here's how I think things played out. Miss Polomare was originally planning on just stealing the fabric and escaping. After she knocked Overall out, she was about to make her exit, but then Coco showed up right behind the victim. After knocking her out too, Miss Polomare realized that she was in the perfect position to get revenge on the pony who had caused her such grave humiliation. That's right. She hanged Overall just to get revenge on Coco Pommel!
Who was that?
Witness?
Shut up! I've had enough of this farce of a trial! Listen to you all! This is what Equestria is depending on as its means of serving justice? This court is an absolute farce!
Now, calm down, witness!
Silence, you senile old fool!
Excuse me? Senile?
Yes, a senile old fool. You're the one who's supposed to be mediating this trial, correct? Then why haven't you put an end to that human lawyer's baseless slandering against me?
Well, he has made some very good—
Shut up!
See? That's exactly what I'm talking about. Even though he has no evidence to support his claims, you just let him prattle on anyway. And you?
Me?
You're supposed to be protecting me, are you not?
But you said you wanted to—
Shut up!
It's not your job to stand there and complain. It's to prosecute that little traitor over there, okay? So why don't you go and get started by debunking this lawyer's theory?
Well,
Ugh. Do I have to do everything myself? Absolutely worthless. Ugh. Seems as if it's not only every pony for themselves in that big city, it's every pony for themselves no matter where you are.
Witness.
What?
You're saying that my theory is completely false. You didn't kill the victim or frame Ms. Palmel for his death.
Of course not.
In that case, I'd like you to testify to the full truth of what you did at the theater that night.
Ugh, fine. Since neither the judge nor the prosecution will help me, I suppose I have to do this myself.
Very well. Witness, please test it.
Shut up! I know what I need to do. Now sit back and listen so the truth doesn't escape this worn-out ears of yours.
Yes, ma'am.
Seems as if we're finally approaching the end of our little play here. Time to make it or break it.
I met with Coco Palmel after receiving a letter from her. After our meeting, I left the room, only to have Overall start chasing me. I ran up to the catwalk, hoping to outrun him. Suddenly, I heard a thud, and I noticed that Overall was on the ground, and the fabric fell out of his mouth. I saw Coco come from behind, grab the roll of fabric, and hit him over the head. She then took his body, wrapped a noose around his neck, and dropped him from the ledge. Coco told me to unwrap the fabric from the roll and leave the building, and I begrudgingly obliged.
You saw Miss Coco murder Mr. Concept?
Yes, I am a witness to the actual crime.
Why did you not mention this to me before? This is crucial information.
Coco told me to keep this a secret. It was her idea after all.
But if this testimony is the truth, then that means you're an accomplice!
It's not as if I wanted to do this. Coco told me to keep quiet about it.
I find that very hard to believe. You honestly think this sudden revelation that Coco somehow forced you to cooperate will convince anyone?
Look, I saw what I saw. And I had to obey because I was afraid I would be her next victim, okay?
She's trying so hard to frame Coco for all of this.
All we gotta do is prove that she didn't do it. I think there's plenty of things she didn't take into account. We just need to show them.
I met with Coco Palmel after receiving a letter from her.
Hold it! What time did you receive this letter?
Well, I found it under my door when I got back to my apartment. It was probably around 4 in the afternoon.
That's odd. I thought she was lying about the letter earlier, but she answered rather quickly there. And what time did you go to the theater?
Well, I knew the play started at 7. And lasted about 2 hours long, so I made sure to arrive at the theater around 8:45.
According to the autopsy report, the time of death was between 8:30 and 9 o'clock. This lines up perfectly. What did you do once you were there?
I met up with Coco in the dressing room. She said she just wanted to catch up after not talking for a while. She and her friend, Overall Concept, were just finishing up coating a sheet of fabric with fluorescent paint. I even accidentally touched some of the wet paint when I went to feel the fabric. Overall scolded me for doing so.
That mostly lines up with what Coco remembers. Is that a lucky guess, or did she actually visit her? Did you do anything else during your visit?
Nothing much, really. As soon as they were done with coating the fabric in paint, Coco left the room for a moment to wash her hooves. There was really nothing left for me to talk about, so I just made my leave. As I did have to wash my hooves as well. However, I suddenly heard some kind of commotion. After our meeting, I left the room, only to have Overall start chasing me.
Hold it! Overall started chasing you?
It was so out of nowhere. He was holding a fabric roll in his mouth, and he just had this very angry look on his face. I think you'd freak out too if a stallion like that just started running towards you.
Can you stop trying to turn it around on me? About this fabric roll, was it bare?
No, it had the fabric Coco and he had just finished working on wrapped around it.
My best guess is he was rolling up the fabric, and then something disturbed him, so he ran out of the dressing room with it.
The victim rolled up the sheet of fabric while it was still wet. I don't buy it. So, how did you react to the situation?
I ran up to the catwalk, hoping to outrun him.
Hold it! Couldn't you have just gone straight for the back door?
I could have, but I saw Coco Pommel on the other side of the backstage area and I didn't want to crash into her, so I went up the catwalk instead.
You saw Miss Pommel?
For a brief moment, yes. She looked very surprised as well.
But wouldn't Playwright have been able to see you going up the catwalk too?
Objection!
You should know the answer to that by now, human. Playwright's testimony stated that he didn't see Miss Polomare go up to the catwalk when he saw the chase. In fact, it was you who suggested that she was far ahead enough that Playwright must have missed her.
He's right. It was me who pointed that out. If anything, this at least confirms my suggestion. I just hope the rest of her testimony can line up with my theory. So what did you do when he reached the top?
I was correct in thinking that going up to the catwalk would slow him down.
What do you mean by that, witness?
Suddenly, I heard a thud, and I noticed that Overall was on the ground, and the fabric fell out of his mouth.
Hold it! He tripped?
Yes, and based on the sound of the clang he made, he must have tripped hard.
Coco and Playwright mentioned something about hearing a clang as well, but would the victim tripping really make such a loud noise? Where did the fabric roll? Roll after he dropped it.
Nowhere really. It just landed right in front of him.
Did you keep running after he tripped?
I was going to originally, but then I saw something quite unsettling. I saw Coco come from behind, grab the roll of fabric, and hit him over the head.
Objection! Miss Polomare, that statement contains a glaring issue.
Glaring?
Care to explain, Mr. Wright?
Certainly. The witness claims that she saw Coco take the fabric roll and hit Overall on the head with it.
I fail to see the problem with that statement.
Well, if you recall, Coco's hooves didn't have a trace of paint on them. If the fabric was wet enough to cover Miss Polomare's hooves in paint, then it should have also covered Coco's when she grabbed it.
It's a fairly simple explanation, human. Remember that this paint could have been washed in the rain. Since this witness stated that Miss Pommel gave the fabric to her and left the theater with it, she didn't need to hide the fabric herself, which means she wouldn't have needed to step outside completely, just far enough out that she could get her hooves wet. You see, this was all part of the defendant's plan to frame Miss Polomare for the crime.
In that case, how do you plan to explain away these other two inconsistencies?
Inconsistencies?
Indeed. They arise from a detail in the autopsy report. Namely, the areas where the fabric roll touched the victim.
What's wrong with that? The autopsy stated that there was a bruise on the back of the head, and if Miss Pommel came from behind, it would naturally be the area where she would strike him.
It's not what's been left behind on Overall's body that's the problem. It's what wasn't left behind.
Huh? What do you mean?
Have you forgotten already? The fabric had just been coated with fluorescent paint, and it was still wet at the time of the crime. If Overall was really holding it in his mouth, there would have been traces of paint left over in his mouth.
Perhaps the paint was washed away by his saliva then.
Even if that were somehow the case, it wouldn't matter. Because there was another spot where the paint couldn't have been washed away.
Couldn't? No!
If Overall was hit on the back of the head with the wet fabric on the fabric roll, then some of the paint would have been discovered there!
What? What's happening? Someone please enlighten me so that I can be shocked too!
Your Honor? The autopsy report states no other substances or residues were found on the victim's body aside from the glitter on his forehooves. We also know, thanks to the previous testimony, that the special fabric was indeed wrapped around the fabric roll at the time of the murder. And it was most definitely still wet.
Oh. Oh!
Based on all this evidence and the testimony presented up to this point, it is impossible for the victim to have been hit on the head with a fabric roll.
What?
Objection!
Then the only other explanation is the roll must have been empty this whole time. It would explain why there were no stains on him.
Objection! Unfortunately, Prince Blueblood, that cannot be the case. A torn piece of fabric was found on stage, indicating that the fabric must have gone up the catwalk at some point. And even if we were to ignore that, the witness herself just claimed that the fabric was on the roll when it was brought up.
Then that must mean that the defendant unwrapped the fabric from the roll as soon as she got up there, and then hit overall with it.
Unless she were a unicorn, unwrapping the roll would have taken far too much time, and overall would have managed to escape without being attacked. No matter what way you try to interpret it, it's impossible for Coco or anyone else to have used the fabric roll to hit the victim.
So, what was the fabric roll used for then, Mr. Wright?
It's become apparent that Suri Polomare was the only one who could have brought the fabric up to the catwalk.
And why's that?
Overall couldn't have done so without getting paint on himself, and Coco couldn't have done it without being seen by Playwright. So there's only one pony left. Process of elimination. Right, Prince Blueblood? So, Miss Polomare, do you deny that you were the one who carried the fabric roll up the catwalk? There's no one else who could have done it, so you might as well—
So what if I did?
Huh?
Listen here, human. Maybe I did steal the fabric. Maybe I did attack Coco Pommel. But here's the thing. This proves nothing!
What do you mean, proves nothing?
You're saying that I knocked both the victim and Coco Pommel out with that fabric roll, right? Well, how exactly did I manage to not leave any traces of paint on the victim myself, then, You're claiming that Coco couldn't have hit the victim with a roll because she would have left paint on him. The same reasoning applies to me, does it not?
That is indeed true. But if you really did go to the theater to steal the fabric, it's possible that you might have prepared a weapon of your own to fend off anyone that would try to stop you.
It's possible? Well, then why don't you go ahead and prove that possibility? I can say for certain that I did not bring a single thing to the theater other than what I have on right now. So go ahead, prove the existence of this other weapon if you can.
Well, Mr. Wright, can you prove the existence of a different weapon the witness could have used to knock out the victim?
Are you kidding me? How am I supposed to do that? I've got no leads to go off of. It could be anything.
Admit it, you have nothing, filthy human. Your Honor?
Yes, Miss Polomare?
I request an escort to take me back to my apartment, and hopefully we can all put this travesty behind us.
I'm afraid you will have to be brought in for questioning before that. You were an accomplice to the defendant, after all. But I'm sure the police can arrange for some form of transportation after that.
Whatever. It's still better than being charged for murder.
No! If I don't think of something now, she's going to get away.
Phoenix!
Twilight, there's nothing! I don't know what she could have used to knock the victim out.
Calm down. There's gotta be something we've overlooked.
How can I calm down now? The real killer is about to get away!
Phoenix, follow my lead.
What was that?
It's a breathing exercise my sister-in-law taught me. She's a princess too, and she taught me this to prepare myself for stressful situations I would have to face as a princess myself.
I see. Wait, your sister-in-law? You have a sibling? And there's another princess?
That's not important right now, Phoenix!
Right. Sorry.
Anyway, we need to think quickly here. Suri must have brought something to the theater that night to use as a weapon.
But the only things she'll admit to having brought with her are the clothes she has on now.
Then let's see if we can use those.
Are you nuts? How could she have knocked someone out with an article of clothing?
We'll think about that later. This is the only lead we have left right now.
Well then, if there are no further objections, I believe it is time we conclude the cross-examination of this witness.
About time, too.
Objection!
Your Honor, the defense would like to present evidence at this time.
Evidence?
Yes, evidence that shows exactly what this witness used to attack overall concept on the night of the murder.
Shut up! Impossible! You can't possibly have anything!
Mr. Wright, please explain what you mean.
I've gotta think fast here. No, not just fast, crazy. Miss Polomare must have somehow knocked out overall with just a piece of clothing. She's not wearing anything else that would be heavy enough to cause such a large bruise on the back of his head, though. So, time to think outside of the box. Instead of figuring out what she used on the victim, let's figure out what she did to him to cause that bruise.
The hard hoof steps from them on the wooden floor were already bad enough. Mix that with a rattling catwalk and that loud clang. That's enough to ruin a play as it is.
On the way up the stairs, I heard a loud clanging noise, and I ran as quickly as I could to see what happened.
Wait, could it be?
Time's up, Mr. Wright. The witness has made some valid points in her defense. Do you have anything to refute them?
I do, Your Honor.
I told you before, I didn't bring a weapon to the theater!
Oh, I believe you. You didn't bring anything of the sort.
But Mr. Wright, wasn't your whole theory based on her having another weapon?
It was, and still is.
Explain, human!
What if this other weapon wasn't a conventional one?
Meaning?
The defense is of the opinion that we've been going about this the wrong way. Recall that playwright mentioned there was a loud clang during the chase.
At least try and keep up, attorney. That was when the victim tripped. We just established this in Miss Polomare's testimony.
I beg to differ.
Huh?
I think that noise was really the moment when Overall was knocked unconscious.
And how would that be? You've admitted that she had no weapon with her. What else could possibly have made that clang? It would have had to have been something metal.
I completely agree. Your Honor, the defense proposes that the witness Suri Polomare knock the victim out using the catwalk itself!
What?
Shut up! Do you hear yourself, human? How in the world would I have been able to use a catwalk as a weapon?
Simple. All you had to do was throw him against it. If he hit the back of his head against the railing hard enough, I'm sure that would have been able to knock him out cold.
That's absolutely ridiculous.
Objection! Impossible, might I add. The witness is a mare of rather petite stature. Are you suggesting that she managed to overpower a fully grown stallion with nothing but her hooves, and then, after doing so, throw him hard enough against the railing to knock him unconscious?
Not quite.
Huh?
You're right that she used the railing to knock him out, but she didn't do so with her bare hooves.
Would this be related to that unconventional weapon you mentioned earlier, by any chance?
Exactly, Your Honor. In fact, she kind of brought it into the court for all to see!
What?
Your Honor, this is the weapon Miss Polomare used to overpower the victim.
Take that!
You're saying she used a scarf?
Recall what the witness just said moments ago.
I can say for certain that I did not bring a single thing to the theater other than what I have on right now.
Nothing other than what she has on. Ah!
Oh! If that's true, then the weapon she used should be clear as day. After making it to the catwalk, she took the scarf off of her neck and waited for the victim to ascend as well. Once he did, she quickly wrapped the scarf around the unsuspecting overall's neck. The two no doubt struggled as he tried to free himself. But as his strength waned, Miss Polomare managed to knock out Overall by throwing him against the catwalk's railing.
Objection! Are you listening to yourself, human? If she had done that, she would have left marks around the victim's neck.
Marks that I'm sure weren't just seen as having been caused by the rope. Am I right? Then, just as Miss Polomare finished incapacitating Overall, who should show up but Coco? After coming across a scene like that, she would have been too on guard for the witness to use her scarf again. So instead, she used the fabric roll she had with her to knock Coco out as well.
Shut up! You... what are you even talking about? I did no such thing. Your Honor, please throw this lawyer out of the courtroom now!
I'm sorry, Miss Polomare, but I can't do that.
Why is that?
Mr. Wright's theory may seem far-fetched, but I cannot deny that what he has proposed is indeed a possibility. Prince Blueblood, any thoughts? Oh dear. It seems we have reached an impasse. I suppose I have no choice but to suspend proceedings of this trial for another—
Hold it! Your Honor, I have evidence to prove my innocence!
You do? Well, let's hear it then!
Very well. Mr. Wright, you're saying that I used my scarf to strangle the victim on the night of the murder, correct?
Well, not exactly to death or anything, but something like that, yes.
In that case, there should be paint marks on my scarf, right? I clearly wasn't aware of the paint that stained my hooves since I left behind a pretty noticeable trail at the scene. So, obviously, that means I wouldn't have washed it to get rid of those marks, correct?
I suppose so.
Then go ahead. I'll give you permission to test my scarf for traces of paint. I promise you, you won't find anything on it.
Well, Mr. Wright, do you wish to request that we test Miss Polomare's scarf?
This feels like a trap. There's no doubt that she was unaware of the paint that night. If she had known, she wouldn't have left such a clear trail behind. In that case, the fact that she so eagerly gave up her scarf for testing can only mean that she's certain that whatever paint she left on has been washed off. So then, the answer should be clear. No, Your Honor.
What?
Why not, Mr. Wright? This could be your only chance to prove your case.
That would be because there's no way that the scarf has any paint left on it.
And how are you so sure of that?
Because last night, at the time of the murder, it was raining outside!
No!
Even though you were completely unaware of the fluorescent paint that night, that doesn't matter in the slightest. Any traces of paint that remained on your hooves or your scarf would have undoubtedly been washed away by the rain as you made your way back home.
You insolent human!
Order! Order! Witness, restrain yourself!
Shut up! You stay out of this. This is between me and that lawyer over there!
Of course, ma'am.
Gee, thanks for nothing, Your Honor.
So, human, since you refuse to let me try and prove my own innocence, how about you show some evidence that proves my guilt?
Your guilt?
Everything you've said so far is all based on circumstantial evidence. The scarf, the fabric, the clothing. You've woven a fascinating yarn, but can you prove it to be true?
She's right. At the moment, this is all just circumstantial. Just conjecture.
but that's about to change very soon.
If you can't prove I killed Overall and framed Coco for it, then cease your baseless accusations, okay?
Well, Mr. Wright, do you have anything that conclusively proves that this witness was the one who killed Overall Concept and then framed the defendant as an act of revenge?
This is it, the final piece of the puzzle. If I can't prove Suri's guilt now, the trial will have to resume tomorrow. Who knows what that could mean for us?
Do you know what we can use now, Phoenix? I don't think any of the evidence is conclusive enough to show that Suri had anything to do with the murder or the framing.
Perhaps not right now, but we may just see it in a moment.
What do you mean?
Suri made one big mistake that night. She got her hooves covered in fluorescent paint. Then, whatever she touched also got contaminated in that paint. And unfortunately for her, she just had to go the extra mile when framing Coco for the crime.
Oh, I see now.
All that's left is to see if we can make it stick.
I won't ask again, Mr. Wright. Present your evidence now, if you have any, to prove that this witness is the real guilty party behind this crime.
He's got nothing. He can't have anything.
I'm afraid that's where you're wrong, Miss Polomare. I do have the evidence that proves that you were the guilty party, and it's right here!
Take that!
Isn't that the fabric roll?
What in Equestria does that prove? There's nothing on there to suggest that I even touched it.
When looking at it normally, you're right. However, we've yet to examine this fabric roll completely.
Completely?
Your Honor, with your permission, I would like to perform one last test with the forensic flashlight. Once I shine it over this fabric roll, we'll see once and for all who really killed Overall Concept.
What? No.
Mr. Wright, I'm afraid I don't understand. How would any traces found on that fabric roll prove who killed the victim?
It's simple, Your Honor. When we adjourned for recess earlier, Coco told me she had regained some of her memories.
Oh? And what did she remember?
Unfortunately, she couldn't remember exactly what had happened on the catwalk, but she did remember everything after she awoke from being knocked out. This fabric roll was resting in her hooves. Hooves, which had suddenly become covered in glitter, despite the fact she had just washed them.
The fabric roll was in her hooves?
If she is to be believed, then this means someone must have placed it there. And there's only one pony who could have done that. Miss Polomare, I'm going to run this flashlight over this fabric roll. If we find your hoof prints on there, left clearly by the paint your hooves were covered in, then I would say this whole case is solved.
No!
Oh! There they are! Quick! Someone analyze them! Prince Blueblood, are the results back yet?
Yes, Your Honor.
And what do they show?
The hoof prints found on the fabric roll match those of Suri Polomare.
It's over, Suri. Now that we know you're responsible for framing Coco, that would naturally mean you were also the one who killed Overall Concept. So, Suri Polomare,
what do you have to say for yourself?
Well, I do believe we've finally come to the conclusion of this trial.
I agree, Your Honor.
If I am to understand correctly, Miss Polomare was the only other pony at the scene of the murder, And all of the evidence points to her. Her motive was to steal a roll of the victim's fabric for the contest she was participating in, and she was caught in the process of stealing it and retaliated against her pursuers. After they were both knocked unconscious, she hung over our concept in an effort to get revenge on her former pupil.
Yes, Your Honor. Everything lines up, and all the facts are in place.
Indeed. I see no room for doubt.
You did it, Phoenix! You won!
All's well that ends well.
No, no! I can't lose! Not to this hairless buffoon!
The truth led us to this conclusion, Blue Blood. There's nowhere else to go from here.
No! No! No, 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 no! I didn't do it! You have to believe me! Please! Somebody help me!
Now then, I believe it is time I hand down my verdict. The court finds the defendant, Coco Pamel.
Hold it! Please hold on for a second!
Coco?
Huh?
Miss Pamel? What are you doing? I was about to hand down your verdict!
Wait! There's something I need to tell you! It's important!
Something important?
What is it, Miss Pamel?
I have an objection to the defense's last statement!
What?
Court! Defendant, what is the meaning of this?
I remember everything!
Remember?
Wait, Coco, you regained all your memory?
Yes, all of it!
What do you mean by all of it?
I can tell you in full detail about the chase, even what happened on the catwalk!
What?
Well, don't just stand there looking adorable! Please, tell the court what you mean!
I... admittedly, I didn't see the moment he fell. But I know for a fact that Suri... she couldn't have been the one who pushed him down!
Huh?
What?
That's...
impossible! Order! Order! Order in the court! Miss Pamel, do you realize what you just said? By doing this, you're incriminating yourself!
Aren't you trying to make a mockery of this court?
Pamel, you stay out of this. This doesn't involve you anymore!
I'm going to be arrested for murder if I don't do something!
Why do you care? You hate my guts! If anything, you should be thrilled about this.
But I'm not! I can't just sit by and watch this happen! If I don't say anything, you're gonna get sent to the moon!
Maybe it's what I deserve for getting myself into trouble all the time.
No, you don't! You keep saying that's every pony for themselves, but that's just not true! I've learned from a great friend that you should always show generosity to others, even if they may not deserve it. So I'm going to help you, whether you want me to or not!
I couldn't care less about why you're doing this. What matters is what this means. Is this you confessing to your crime, defendant?
Not at all. If it's all right, I'd like to explain what I saw on the night of the murder.
Coco, what else is there left to be said? It's been proven that Miss Bullemare was behind this. I understand how you must feel, but...
Please, Mr. Wright! I have to do this! I have to save her! I trust her. She would never kill any pony! And you trust me, right? You told me so. So please, let me testify. Let me tell you what really happened that night.
All right, Coco.
Really?
If you're that certain of your own testimony, then I trust you. Your Honor.
Yes?
Please allow my client to testify. From it, we should be able to find the real truth of this case.
Very well. Miss Pommel, please testify about what you witnessed at the night of the murder.
Thank you, Your Honor. And you too, Mr. Wright.
Okay.
We're in uncharted waters now. The only thing I really know is that whatever it is Coco has to say will lead us to the truth.
I was returning from the restroom after washing my hooves with the paint and glitter. I suddenly saw Overall running up to the catwalk, and then I quickly followed him. While running up the stairs, I heard a loud bang from above. When I reached the top of the catwalk, I saw Suri looking over the edge with a special fabric in her mouth. I ran to her to ask where Overall was, but then she swung the roll of my head, and I was knocked out! When I came to, I looked down for the catwalk and saw Overall hanging with a rope tied around his neck. Before I could even scream, Pleary found me, and I just stood where I was until the police came.
That seems to be quite consistent with what the defense has already uncovered.
Yes, but if you'll let me explain further...
Objection!
Why are we continuing with this charade? Is this your handiwork, dirty human? Did you set this up just to rub my defeat in my face?
Of course not. It's our duty as keepers of the law to find the truth. The whole truth. If all you care about are your own personal victories, then I suggest you find a different occupation.
You little blue kitten! You dare disrespect me! Me! Prince Blueblood! Nephew to Princess Celestia!
I don't care who you are! I'm here to find the truth! And if you aren't here to do the same, then the only experience you're gonna get with these trials is how to severely damage your own judicial system.
You!
Enough! Mr. Wright, please begin your cross-examination.
I was returning from the restroom after washing my hooves with the paint and glitter.
Hold it! Are you certain that you were able to wash everything off?
Yes, I did. I knew that I was dealing with fluorescent paint, so I had to be thorough with my washing. I actually had to turn off the lights while washing my hooves to see if I got everything off.
Is it that difficult to wash off?
As long as it's still wet, it's manageable. It's not as easy when it's dry, though. That's why I had to wash my hooves immediately.
So, why didn't Overall have any paint on his hooves? He was working with you, right?
Yeah, but he was mostly just showing me how to properly paint the fabric, so he barely touched the stuff.
I see. You also said that you were returning to the dressing room. Anything in particular that seemed off while heading back?
Well, something like that. I suddenly saw Overall running up to the catwalk, and then I quickly followed him.
Hold it! Did you see anyone else before you saw Overall?
No, I only saw him. Or at least, that's all I could see when I looked.
What do you mean by that?
While I was on my way back, I was listening to the play. I was really happy with how great the actors were doing, and it sounded like their best performance yet! I only noticed that something was wrong when I heard loud hoofsteps, and that was when I looked ahead towards the dressing room. I only saw Overall sprinting out of the dressing room for a split second.
Did you see which direction he was running to?
He looked like he was heading towards the stage. I even called his name, hoping he would respond, but he didn't say anything. I was really worried.
And that's when you started running after him?
Yes, I had to find out what the problem was. When I next caught sight of him, I saw that he was near the top of the stairs to the catwalk. I was afraid he would trip because it was so dark, so I turned on the safety lights to make sure he was safe.
Right. She said that earlier, and that's why the safety lights were turned on during the crime. So, when you ran up the stairs to the catwalk, was there anything that you saw that struck you as strange?
It's not exactly what I saw that caught my attention. It's what I heard.
What did you hear, defendant?
While running up the stairs, I heard a loud clang from above.
Hold it!
How loud exactly would you say it was?
Pretty loud, actually. I'm sure that the others who were near the stage would have heard it too.
That's right. Wright said he heard the same thing in his testimony. I thought Ms. Pilomare knocked out the victim with the railing. Could it have been something else? She also mentioned it in her testimony, after all. How did you react to the noise?
It startled me! It made me even more worried for Overall! I had to see what was going on up there!
What did you see when you got to the top?
When I reached the top of the catwalk, I saw Suri looking over the edge with a special fabric in her mouth.
Hold it!
You saw Miss Pilomare?
I recognized her the instant I saw her. I never thought I would ever see her again after quitting as her assistant.
Do you recall her reaction to seeing you?
She looked very shocked. In fact, she looked just as shocked to see me as she did when she was staring over the edge of the catwalk.
Did you see her holding anything other than the fabric?
No. All she had was a rolled up fabric. I didn't see anything else.
What about her scarf? Did you see it?
I did, and it was securely wrapped around her neck. There's no way she could have taken it off and put it back on so quickly. I'm sure of it.
And just to confirm, the special fabric was rolled up and used to knock you unconscious.
Yes, it was rolled up.
This has already been established. You're just poking holes into your own theory now.
And what about Overall? Where was he?
Well, he wasn't anywhere.
What do you mean?
When I got to the top of the catwalk, all I saw was Suri. Overall was nowhere to be seen.
What?
Miss Pomel, are you suggesting that Overall just disappeared?
I don't know. I was confused too. But that's what I saw. He wasn't on the catwalk at all.
Well, this throws a wrench into my theory. If Overall wasn't on the catwalk by the time Coco made it up there, that could only mean...
You don't think that the victim had already been hanged by the time he got up there, do you?
Now that you mention it, I did hear the crowd panicking when I got to the top. And I'm sure whatever Suri saw gave her that expression when she looked down. It's possible. She was looking at the body.
What? But how is that possible? Prince Blueblood, what's so funny?
Isn't it obvious, Your Honor? The defense has managed to disprove his own theory with his client's testimony.
He has?
Go on, filthy human. Say it. Admit that according to Miss Pomel's testimony, Miss Pilomare cannot possibly be the killer, and as a result, the only other one it could be is the defendant.
Well, Mr. Wright, is that true? Do you have nothing left to support your own theory?
Watch, Your Honor. The attorney there will clearly opt to strike all of the defendant's testimony from the record.
Please, Mr. Wright! You have to believe me! I know it ruins the case you built, but it's all true! I swear!
Blueblood's right. I could easily have this testimony discarded and go straight for a not guilty verdict. But Coco risked everything to bring this information to light. She must really believe that Miss Pilomare is innocent. And given the testimony she's provided so far, it certainly seems to be the case. She's trusting me to save some pony she cares about. And I'm not about to betray that trust.
Your Honor, the defense will not have the defendant's testimony stricken from the record.
You won't? But that means...
Yes, we're accepting the defendant's testimony as truth.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Mr. Wright.
Then Does that mean you have evidence to prove how Miss Polomare could have committed the crime under these new circumstances?
No, Your Honor, we do not.
What? But wasn't she your prime suspect for the theft and the framing and the murder?
I do still believe that she stole the fabric and framed Coco. However, I am certain, based on Coco's testimony, that she was not the one who killed Overall Concept.
I see. And what, pray tell, do you think can prove your point? After all, there's nothing to suggest that the defendant is even telling the truth here, is there?
Talk about showing your hand. Blue Blood's clearly baiting me into presenting this evidence. He knows what it will prove if I do. But there's no way to go but forward. My only hope now lies with her.
Your Honor, the defense would like to present a piece of evidence at this time. Evidence that will reveal the truth behind this incident once and for all.
Are you sure about this, Mr. Wright?
Absolutely, Your Honor.
Take that!
Isn't that the noose used in the crime?
Earlier, we determined that Miss Polomare had touched the fabric roll by finding traces of fluorescent paint on it. Now, what do you suppose we'll find if we examine this with a forensics flashlight?
Well, if she's the culprit, I'd imagine there'd be traces of paint on the rope.
And if there isn't, then that would mean that she's innocent of this murder, correct?
Yes, I suppose so. But do you know what you're doing, Mr. Wright?
I couldn't be more certain, Your Honor.
Very well. Then please, test the rope for fluorescent paint. There's no paint! There's no paint on the rope!
Foolish attorney! You've fallen right into my trap!
Prince Blueblood, what do you mean?
Your Honor, as we've all seen, this rope has no fluorescent paint on it, which means that Miss Polomare cannot be the killer. In which case, the only other clue left as to the identity of the killer are the traces that were found on the rope.
The other traces?
If you recall, Your Honor, this rope had traces of glitter found around the noose.
Oh, that's right!
This must mean that someone who had glitter-covered hooves must have been the one to wrap the noose around the victim's neck. There were only two ponies who had the opportunity to do that after the victim was knocked out, and both of them would have had glitter on their hooves. Miss Pommel and Miss Polomare. However, now that we know that there was no paint on the rope, that rules out the witness, leaving the defendant as the only possible suspect.
Oh! That's right!
What? No! It wasn't me!
Silence, you criminal! It's impossible for you to escape your punishment now. Isn't that right, defense?
Objection! But Coco couldn't have used the fabric roll to knock the victim out. There's no way she could be the killer.
Objection! Just because she couldn't have knocked the victim out doesn't mean she can't be the killer.
Why not?
Have you already forgotten what your spiky-headed friend has already demonstrated? That Miss Polomare here was the one who knocked the victim unconscious by throwing him against the catwalk railing using her scarf?
No.
After incapacitating the victim, likely because she was trying to stop him from catching her after stealing the fabric, Miss Pommel showed up on the scene and proceeded to hang the victim.
Objection! But Coco had cleaned off all the glitter on her hooves before going up the catwalk. Sari even testified that Coco had gone to do so.
Objection! However, she has not confirmed that the defendant did, in fact, have clean hooves when she arrived on the scene.
But...
It's the end of the line for you, defense. Am I wrong, Mr. Wright?
Alright, everything is going according to plan. Even though it's now clear who killed the victim, I think it's time we remove the last traces of doubt from the court's mind.
Well, Mr. Wright, do you have anything that can refute the prosecution's claim?
I don't, Your Honor, but someone here does.
And who would that be, Mr. Wright?
Isn't it obvious? The one pony who can testify for certain exactly when Coco's hooves were covered in glitter. Surrey Pullomare!
What?
You honestly think she's going to testify for you now? What a joke! You just accused her of a murder she never even committed! Why in Equestria do you think she would want to help you?
Surrey, you've always believed that it's every pony for themselves in the big city, right? And yet, as we just seen, Coco put her own life on the line to protect you. She saved you from being charged with a murder you didn't commit. Now, it's your turn to save her.
My turn?
Yes. If you confess to everything you did that night, and everything you saw, it will prove Coco's innocence beyond all doubt.
Confess.
I've done everything I can to help Coco. And your testimony, your confession, is the last piece I need to completely prove her innocence. However, you must tell the truth this time. We aren't going to get another shot at this.
Please, Surrey, I trust you. You'll do the right thing. I know it.
You trust me?
I do.
Enough of this melodrama. The game is up, attorney. She is not going to testify for...
Fine, then. I confess.
What?
What are you confessing to, witness?
I confess to stealing the fabric and attacking Coco.
You're admitting that it was you?
Silence yourself! You're going to ruin my-
Shut up! I don't care about your case, okay? I'm gonna tell the whole truth of that night, whether you want me to or not.
Will none of you treat me with the respect I deserve? I am Prince Blueblood, nephew of-
Witness, I hope you realize that these are not minor offenses you are confessing to.
I am well aware, Your Honor. But I refuse to just stand by and let Coco take the blame for this murder.
Surrey!
Don't misunderstand me. I've not been moved by your sentimental pleas for help. I don't want to have to owe you or that attorney any favors in the future.
Of course.
Well then, witness, please proceed with your confession.
That night, I went to the theater of my own volition. I was there to steal the fabric, as Mr. Wright predicted, and yes, I attacked Coco in the process.
But the fabric's existence was only known to Coco, Overall, and Playwright, and those whom they told. How did you come by this knowledge?
I can't say.
Why not?
Look, I just can't, okay? Don't ask about it anymore, or I will be withdrawing my confession.
Very well. Although I can't help but be curious. So, what exactly happened after you entered the theater?
I went to the theater through the back door, just like you said, and made my way to the dressing room. There were two ponies in there, Coco and Overall. I kept my eyes on the room and the surrounding area, waiting for an opportunity to take the fabric. After Coco left the room, I hid behind a curtain so that I would not be seen. Overall was still in there, but I figured this would be the best chance I had to steal the fabric.
I waited until his back was turned and then entered the room. I quietly picked up a wooden roll that was sitting on the table and began rolling up the fabric that had been left out.
I see. But to actually manage to sneak in and roll up the fabric, something else must have captured Overall's attention. Something to keep him occupied long enough to allow for Siri to do what she did. I doubt she would have been successful otherwise. But what could it have been? So, what happened next?
I managed to roll the fabric up unnoticed, but Overall noticed me as I was leaving and he started chasing me. I bolted for the back door, but I noticed Coco Pommel coming back to the dressing room. Before she had a chance to see me, I went straight for the catwalk, hoping that Overall would be slow climbing up so that I could escape. The lights came on as I turned the corner, but I paid them no mind and kept running. As soon as I reached the end of the catwalk, I heard a loud bang behind me. And when I look back, Overall was just...
That lines up with what Coco said.
But he was just chasing you. How could he have just disappeared like that?
I was just as lost as you are. I was happy that he wasn't chasing me anymore, but that noise worried me. So I went back to see what had happened. I started hearing screams of terror from the audience. With my worries growing, I looked down and what I saw was Overall's body hanging from the catwalk.
What in the...
What? Order! Order, I say! Witness, are you saying that the victim was hanged during your chase?
It sounds crazy, I know, but that's what I saw. I was about to run for the back door before the police had a chance to arrive, but as I was looking down at the body, Coco had come up on the catwalk as well. I was freaking out. She was wondering where Overall was, and she started moving towards me. I didn't know what to do, and I was too afraid of being caught stealing his fabric and possibly being seen as a killer. So I took the fabric roll, and I swung it as hard as I could on Coco's head and knocked her out.
This cannot be.
It was at that point that a certain thought occurred to me. I can use this. I can frame her. Get back at her for everything.
What?
So you really were trying to plant the whole thing on the defendant?
Coco and that pressy unicorn Rarity. They both ruined me. I was seen as a cheater in the fashion world. I was humiliated. I wanted payback. So I removed the fabric from the roll, as I was still intending on keeping it. However, in my haste to remove the fabric, I accidentally tore a piece of it off in the process.
How did you do that?
I think the answer to that question would be because of the exposed splinters on the fabric roll. Correct?
You got it. A bit of the fabric got caught on a splinter and tore off as I unwrapped it. I tried to catch it before it fell, but it was too late. Luckily, it went unnoticed thanks to the panic as a result of the hanged body. Once I had the fabric off the roll, I shook off some of the glitter onto Coco's hooves and placed the fabric roll itself between them.
That would explain why the glitter left on the catwalk was in a pile. You quickly dropped it in one place instead of wasting precious time by spreading it about.
That's right. After I had covered both Coco's hooves and the fabric roll in glitter, I placed the roll in Coco's hooves to complete the picture that Coco had attacked and hung the victim. Finally, I fled down the left side of the catwalk and left the building.
Leaving a trail of footprints in fluorescent paint behind you, for us to find.
I didn't even know that paint was on the fabric in the first place. I only found out when it was brought up during this trial. I didn't really pay attention to what Coco and Overall were working on in the dressing room, and the lights were on when I stopped running on the catwalk. I was completely unaware I had left any prints. Even after I got home, I wasn't aware of the paint. The rain must have washed it off my hooves and the fabric.
And this is the full truth this time, right, witness?
Yes. Every last thing I saw and did that night. So there, Mr. Wright, you have my confession. I stole the fabric, attacked Coco, and framed her for murder. Now the ball's in your court to save her.
Very well. Thank you for your cooperation, Miss Pelomere.
Don't lose any sleep over it.
As much as I hate to be the bearer of bad news to you all, this proves nothing. The defendant is still the only one who could have committed the crime.
Objection!
Then you must not have been listening to the confession at all, Prince Blueblood. If you had been, it should be clear that there's no way Coco was responsible for this.
Explain then, if you can.
According to the confession that was just given, not only was Coco not even on the catwalk when the victim was hanged, but Miss Pelomere herself admitted just now that it was she who covered the defendant's hooves in glitter.
No!
And since that's the case, then it's impossible for Coco to have been the one to leave the traces of glitter on the noose. That in conjunction with her exact whereabouts at the exact time of the murder should prove beyond any doubt that Coco Pommel is innocent.
No! No!
Order! Order in the court! Mr. Wright, you—
Objection!
This is impossible! Human, if neither pony could have murdered Overall, then who are you proposing is the true culprit? There was no one else on that catwalk who could have done it!
Are you certain about that? Aren't you forgetting someone? One other pony that was on the catwalk at the time of the crime.
No! You can't be serious!
Mr. Wright, are you suggesting—
It seems as though we finally arrived at the truth, as much as I don't want to believe it, or even fully understand why. This is the only possibility left.
I am, Your Honor.
Phoenix! You aren't going to—
The one responsible for taking the victim's life was the only other pony who was at the crime scene when he was hanged. And that, of course, would be the victim himself. Overall concept!
What
the—
Hello?
Order! Order! Order in the court! Mr. Wright, have you completely lost your mind? Are you suggesting that the victim committed suicide?
That's exactly what I'm suggesting.
Objection!
Are you crazy? There is nothing in the evidence or testimony that suggests suicide.
I have to agree here, Phoenix. Murder is already rare enough in Equestria, but suicide? That's entirely unheard of!
I figured as much. But despite how improbable it may be, it's the only logical conclusion I can think of that can solve this case.
Logical? How can you even call this logical? You have a good explanation for this, human.
Although I can't claim to know why the victim would do this, I can't hazard a guess to what happened that night. Overall concept, after chasing Miss Pelomere up to the catwalk, grabbed the rope that was prepared by the stagehands during intermission. Wrapping it around his neck, he jumped over the railing to his death. We've heard testimonies from both defendant and witness, and together, they prove rather conclusively that Overall was the only other one on the catwalk at the time of the crime. If neither of them could have done it, then it could have only been the victim himself.
Objection!
Your delusions have utterly ruined your sense of reason, human! Time to bring you back to reality. The victim was unconscious due to a blow to the head at the time of his death. We meant to believe that he committed suicide while he was unconscious?
Of course not. But we may have made an incorrect assumption regarding this blow to the head.
What do you mean?
We all came to the conclusion that the victim was unconscious because he was knocked out by someone. But that's where we were wrong. It wasn't because he was attacked. He was knocked unconscious after hitting his head against something as he was falling.
What?
What could the victim have even hit his head on?
Might I suggest he hit the back of his head on the catwalk rail? He must have not jumped far enough and received a pretty nasty bruise as a result, which knocked him unconscious.
How outrageous! And I suppose you have something to support that claim?
The clang that Suri, Coco, and Playwright heard. It was the sound of the victim's head colliding with the railing.
Objection!
You can't be serious, human! This theory of suicide, it's completely baseless! I demand to see real, physical evidence that points to this ridiculous assertion being the truth!
I have it right here.
Take that!
The autopsy report? Does that prove anything?
Right here, where it says the victim had traces of glitter on his forehooves.
So what? That doesn't prove anything.
Hmm? Prince Blueblood, what's the matter?
He's finally realized the truth, Your Honor. As we've established, there are traces of glitter around the noose. The two ponies who were most likely to have left glitter on it could not have done so. The lack of fluorescent paint clears Ms. Polymer, and the noose had already been thrown off the catwalk by the time the defendant arrived. Not to mention, Ms. Polymer admitted that she was the one who coated Coco's hooves in glitter after the victim died. Therefore, there was only one other pony who could have left glitter on the noose. The only other pony who had traces of glitter on his hooves and went up the catwalk at the time of the crime.
Overall concept!
Objection!
You haven't won yet. You still haven't explained why the victim would take his own life. He was living happily and was even planning to propose to the defendant. And on top of all of that, if he was planning on committing suicide, why do it in the middle of a play, in front of thousands of ponies in the audience? You don't have an answer, do you? I knew it!
You're right. I don't have an answer why the victim decided to commit suicide. But that's not something that needs to be determined here and now.
What?
The purpose of this trial was to ascertain whether or not the defendant, Coco Pommel, was guilty of the murder of Overall Concept. Through the testimony and evidence that's been presented, I'd say the answer to that question has been made abundantly clear by now. As for why the victim chose to end his own life, I'd say that's up to the police to investigate and discover the truth behind that mystery.
As much as I share everyone else's confusion, I have to agree with the defense.
What? You're actually going along with this?
There is simply no other explanation, I'm afraid. I would like to request that the police continue their investigation in order to uncover further information regarding this supposed suicide. As for Suri Polomare, you will be placed under arrest for perjury, theft, and tampering with the crime scene.
Whatever. It sure beats getting sent to the moon. Just make sure that sentence isn't too long. I have dresses to work on, okay?
Well, Mr. Wright, even in another world, you haven't lost your knack for taking a seemingly ordinary murder case and turning it onto its head. Not bad for your first time back in Equestria, I must say.
Oh, thanks, Your Honor. I can't tell if he's complimenting me or calling me out.
Still, sometimes I wish you would stop for a moment. I'm an old man. I don't know how much more of this my heart can take.
Yes, sorry, Your Honor. Okay, maybe he is calling me out.
But as of right now, I think it's time I hand down my verdict in the case of Miss Pommel.
No! How can I lose? How can I lose to this hairless ape? A perfect win streak! No!
We won!
And what a bumpy ride this trial was.
In the case of Miss Coco Pommel, I find the defendant... Court is now adjourned.
Whoa, now that was an ending I certainly didn't expect.
But you still managed to pull through. Congrats, boss! And you too, Twilight!
Yes! Thank you so much, Phoenix! You saved Coco!
All in a day's work, Rarity.
Woo! Daddy wins the case once again! But of course, was there ever any doubt?
Drucy, there's no need to shower me with praise. Honestly.
But it's true! I can never count you out in trial. And you sure taught that prince not to underestimate you in there.
It was so satisfying seeing him fall apart. Especially after going after my dear Coco. Oh, here she comes now!
Hello, everypony.
Hello there, Coco.
Coco! Congrats on getting your acquittal, dear.
Thank you, Rarity. I'm very glad.
Oh? Then, why the long face, darling?
Well, I'm happy that I'm off the hook, but I'm still sad about Overall passing away, especially now that I know how he really died. How could he just do that to himself? Was something hurting him? Was it me?
Miss Pommel?
Yes?
I've studied analytical psychology, so I want to give you my opinion. You are absolutely not responsible for what happened to Overall.
I can't know that!
You mentioned earlier in the trial that Overall had a bout of depression following the death of his parents, right?
Well, yes. But that was years ago, and he never seemed upset once we started living together.
It's not uncommon for someone to have periods of depression separated by years where they feel and act perfectly normal. I think Overall may have been suffering from it without anyone realizing. Granted, we can't know for sure, but that's what I think anyway.
Even still, he probably wasn't happy with me.
That couldn't be farther from the truth, Coco. Remember this ring Overall was going to propose to you with? He clearly was at his happiest when he was with you. It's true we may not know his true reasons for ending his own life, but I know that you were not the reason.
But I could have done something about it. Maybe I should have talked to him more, probably been more involved with his designs. If only I didn't leave the dressing room, he would have stayed alive. If only I...
Hey, calm down.
Huh?
Take a breather. You'll hurt your vocal cords yelling like that.
Okay.
Listen, you shouldn't blame yourself for Overall's death. There was nothing you could have done.
But if only you were with him the entire time, then he would have—
But it happened anyway! I understand what you're going through. You thought you could have done something to prevent losing a loved one, but the entire situation was beyond your control. You shouldn't put the burden on yourself. You'll never be able to live in the present if you stay in the past. Besides, in some way, your friend still lives on.
What do you mean?
He may be gone, but but his spirit isn't. He was a teacher to you, right? If you learned from him, you're allowing his techniques to live on as well. So in some way, he's always with you.
Of course. Overall was teaching you his ways, and I know you've learned so much from him. Now it's up to you to carry on his legacy. Even though he's gone, I know you'll make sure he is never forgotten.
Thank you, Mr. Wright. Rarity and, what are your names?
I'm Apollo. Apollo Justice.
And I'm Athena Cykes.
Thank you. All of you, thank you so much. I think I feel a little better now. But I don't know how he could possibly live up to Overall's expectations. He always made sure his designs were perfect. And now that he's gone, all of his assets go to me, including his sketches for new designs. They'll be his final pieces of work and they look fantastic. But once it's my turn to design something, I don't know how I could possibly make something of that caliber on my own, compared to somebody who played such a big role in the theater industry. I don't know if I'm good enough to do it.
Actually, Coco, you're more talented than you'd let yourself believe.
Pyrrha! What are you doing here?
I just wanted to apologize for thinking that you were the one who killed Overall.
It's quite all right, sir. I was the only one up there, after all.
I know, but this human proved otherwise. Coco, I know you think you may not reach Overall's expectations, but I believe you'll do fine. You were under his wing, after all.
But sir, he was so much more skilled than me. I don't see...
Miss Pommel, I need you to listen to me.
Hmm?
During this trial, I've seen that perfection isn't always the best thing to aim for. While it's nice that you can believe that you can achieve something great, the sacrifices you make to get there aren't always worth it. In fact, it may have been partially my fault for Overall taking his own life.
What? Why?
I was so obsessed with making my plays perfect that I never realized how I've often mistreated my staff members. Without a doubt, this applies to both you and Overall. I was a terrible leader. So, from now on, instead of striving for perfection, I will do my best to achieve something greater that all of us can be proud of. Not just for me and you, but for the rest of the staff as well.
Playwright, I...
Overall told me time and time again that your skills had even surpassed his own. In fact, when he came on stage during intermission that night, he wanted to talk to me about letting you design costumes for the show after the next. He said that it was time that your own work became known and that this was a perfect opportunity. At the time, I said I'd think about it, but admittedly I was going to reject his request. However, that's all changed now. In honor of Overall's last wish to me, I hereby promote you, Miss Pommel, head costume designer for Broadway Theater.
Oh, sir, thank you. I will do my best to make sure that my designs will be the best they can be.
I'm sure you will. That twinkle in your eye, you're really just like Overall, you know? Come on, let's get back to the theater. I want to make sure the staff knows you are all right.
Of course, sir. We still need to make some costumes for the next play anyway. And I certainly will have my own ideas to implement.
That's the spirit, darling. And once you do design some of your own clothes, I'd be happy to sell them in my store for you. I could even use some of Overall's special fabric as inspiration for my next clothing line, if you'll allow me to have some.
Of course, Rarity. Anything for a dear friend. Well, see you later, everypony.
And there they go.
What's wrong, Twilight?
Oh, it's nothing. I'm just glad to see Coco so happy. I know, right? I can hear a lot of happiness coming from her. Playwright did a great job cheering her up. I can hear lots of happiness from him as well.
I must confess, I've actually never seen Playwright this happy before.
Really?
You see,
Playwright hasn't always been in the best of moods. At least whenever I visited the theater.
Well, he did say that he's always been striving for perfection. I can only imagine the emotional stress he puts himself in, day out.
Indeed. His never-ending desire to achieve perfection made him so stubborn and short-tempered. And it put the staff under a lot of stress. I was very upset with how unfairly he treated every pony.
Being the element of generosity, I can understand why that would upset you.
But this is the first time he considered the well-being of others. He was only ever remotely happy when he thought he was close to perfection. I've never seen him show this much sympathy for any pony else.
Showing sympathy to others is an easy way to let them know that we care about what happens to them. Bringing negative emotions to your peers will only spread more negativity, and that leads to an unhealthy environment. This tragedy must have given him that revelation.
He looked like a very different pony, and I'm happy that he's changed for the better.
And Coco seems to be a lot stronger, too.
And I'm so proud of her for that. Now she's off to forge her own path. I can't wait to see what else she has to offer the fashion world.
Yep, it seems as if everyone is moving on to bigger and better things. Although I can't help but feel a little unsatisfied with the way the trial ended.
Unsatisfied? What do you mean?
Well, there were still some unanswered questions at the end of it all. The most notable one being, why did Overall Concept take his own life?
That's something I can't begin to fathom. Overall was certainly a very happy individual. Even with depression possibly being a factor, his life seemed to only be getting better and better. With his fame, job, and even some pony he cared enough about to want to propose to them, he never seemed like the kind of pony to even consider suicide.
It makes me wonder too, but unfortunately, there is no clear answer. Let's hope that the police can investigate further and find out the truth soon.
I suppose. But hey, you showed that prissy prince who's boss! I definitely enjoyed myself seeing his face as he smelt defeat!
Yeah, he's quite the character, isn't he? Oh, that reminds me. Twilight, I have a question for you.
Hmm? What is it, Phoenix?
You said that Prince Blue Blood was prosecuting for experience when he can rule a kingdom, correct?
Yes, that's correct.
And as princess, you're able to stand in court as an attorney as well, correct?
Yes,
So, what I'm trying to understand is, why did you feel the need to summon me when it seems as if you could have handled this whole situation yourself?
Huh?
I know you're capable of doing it. You saved me quite a few times in court today. You've clearly been studying law for a while now, even if this is your first real time practicing it. In fact, didn't you say that ponies who are of royalty need experience in upholding the law? Considering you're a princess, doesn't that technically mean you have an obligation to represent Miss Pommel?
Oh, well, when Rarity told me the story, I didn't exactly have a lot of time to think about who would represent Coco, so I just summoned you.
That doesn't really make sense, Twilight. Summoning me would have meant you would have had to gone through the trouble of getting an equestrian attorney's badge ready again. Also, the one accused of murder is a friend of your friend, and considering you're the princess of friendship? That's more of a reason to take on the case yourself. You did say that you've been studying law ever since you became a princess. The more I think about it, the less I understand it. If you appear so capable of taking on a case, why did you feel the need to summon me?
What? Cyclox?
What's wrong, Phoenix?
Nothing. Forget I asked. What does this mean? What is Twilight trying so hard to hide from me?
Hi, Beanie!
Where in the world did you come from, Pinky?
Ask my parents, Feeny.
Heya, Pinky.
Heya, Trucy.
Oh, Pinky, where were you sitting in the gallery? I didn't see you.
I was with Fluttershy and Applejack, so she certainly wasn't with me.
She wasn't with me, Apollo, or Trucy either.
Yeah, I was late. Late? This is clearly an important trial to us. I know Rainbow had some wonderful dessert business to attend to, but how could you possibly be late? I slept in. Again? I can't help it. I had one of those really fun dreams, and I didn't want them to stop. So I tried sleeping some more.
Doesn't this pony have a day job? How has she not been fired already?
Hey, I have a job. I'm in the Cheeky Corner helping the cakes make cakes. And I'm also a party extraordinaire. So I help throw parties that'll shake your flank all night.
With the amount of energy it takes to party that hard, it makes sense that you sleep for so long.
So why did you come to us, Pinky?
Don't you remember, Feeny? Congratulations on winning the trial party!
Ooh! You already have that party ready?
Yep, sure did! I already got the cakes, the drinks, the guests, and decorations ready! I even brought a DJ to the party, too!
Cakes? Drinks? Guests?
And decorations? And even a DJ? This party is gonna be wild!
This sounds like a very stacked party. When did you get everything prepared?
I got it prepared as soon as I woke up.
Wow, that must have taken forever to prepare.
It wasn't hard. I do this all the time.
Wait, hold on a second. I thought you slept in. How did you get the time to prepare a big party like that?
By doing it quickly, silly.
So then, when did you wake up?
Wait. Doesn't it take a couple of hours to get to Manhattan from Ponyville? But I thought you said you woke up a couple of hours ago.
I sure did.
But that means the second you woke up,
you fully prepared a big party
and caught the train here
in a matter of minutes?
Hey, yep, sure sounds like it.
But that's...
How were you able to prepare a party that big in such a small span of time?
I told you, Polly, by doing it quickly.
What?
You'd be amazed at what this pink mare is capable of, Apollo.
She just has great work ethic, Polly. You could learn a thing or two from her.
Give me a couple hundred clients and maybe I'll consider taking lessons.
Boss, does this pink pony have time powers? There's no way she's capable of that.
Nah, that's just Pinkie Pie being Pinkie Pie. You better just get used to it.
But what does that even mean?
Just trust me on this. It's for your own sake.
As if this world isn't testing it enough.
Hey, Pinkie, if you want, I'd like to have a magic performance at your party.
A human doing a magic show? That sounds exciting! I've always wanted to see a human do magic!
I'm the best magician in the city where I'm from! I can guarantee you all a good show!
Well, that sounds like it'll be a wonderful time!
I'm certainly looking forward to it! Hopefully, I don't get forced to dance until I throw my back out.
Come on, every pony! Let's get to the party!
Right behind you, Pinky!
And as quickly as it started, the case came to a close. Pinky threw a party for all of us to celebrate, and it was actually very enjoyable. Like a little vacation, it was a nice change of pace from what I usually do after a trial. Fortunately, this little moment of sunshine and rainbows wouldn't last forever. Unbeknownst to us, something darker was lurking in the shadows of this colorful world. Something that teased at a broader mystery. And little did any of us realize that during our carefree celebration, that mystery would continue to unfold not too far from us. It's a mystery I won't soon forget. as it brought me to someone that I thought I would never see again. Someone who's a spitting image of a dear friend I knew a long time ago.
Knock, knock! Rise and shine, inmate! Guess what day it is? That's right. As of today, you're a free mayor. It must feel nice to finally be out after 8 months, huh? Right, well, you're lucky that human defense attorney proved that you didn't murder any pony. You probably would have been banished to the moot if you hadn't. As for your possessions, just these. You left them back in the courtroom. Well, this is it. But before you leave, I want to ask you something. Now that you're out, what are you gonna do?
I'm going to help those that need it. Just like he did for me.